the years, the Hawaii Theater has welcomed many productions to tell stories from around the world.
You have to say it in your
best
voice.
From around the world.
But what about the stories that Hawaii Theater holds? Here's our Mikey Moniz, who's joining us live from the Hawaii Theater with more. Hello there, Michael.
That's good.
Why do the lambs cry, Clarice? That's a dry Saturday.
Boiled, boiled, boiled.
Hi, Fred. Everybody, this is Greg Dunn. He's with Hawaii Theater. We're celebrating World Theater Day.
Oh, my gosh. How exciting.
So crazy. Let's talk about World Theater Day. But before we honor today, let's go back in time real quick. Tell us the history of Hawaii Theater, because it's pretty interesting.
So 1922, the theater opened. The Magoon family were the owners of Consolidated Amusements, and they visualized having a Pride of the Pacific, a grand, opulent show place, a theater for live performance and eventually movies. They spent $500,000 or more on building the theater then. Today, it would be over $50 million to replace the Hawaii Theater.
Wow. Okay, wait. So how much did it cost to actually build the theater from the ground up?
In 1922 dollars, $500,000.
Wow. That's insane. Okay, so we were talking about earlier about if you guys wanted to support theater, especially Hawaii Theater, people can do so online, right?
Yep. At HawaiiTheater.com. It's theatre.com. We have a donation page set up. We're looking for funds. Right now, we're trying to raise money to paint the exterior of the building.
Okay.
When the theater was remodeled, restored in 1996, we didn't have enough money to paint the outside and repair the concrete spalling. Mm-hmm. It's something we're raising money for right now.
I love that. Okay, so something interesting that I learned about Hawaii Theater is that it used to be a movie house. Okay, tell us a little bit about that. So this is kind of the original, consolidated theater, really.
It was one of the main, it was the big flagship. So silent movies started out. The first show that was supposed to be in the theater in the opening in 1922 was The Three Musketeers, silent movie version.
Oh, wow.
But the movie was stuck offshore on a boat because of a storm, so we had a live performance on stage instead.
What?
Then over time, movies came back in, silence, then talkies, and then during the 70s and 80s, it got a little bit racy in Chinatown.
Okay.
And so the theater had some of the more avant-garde films, as we like to say today.
Avant-garde, that's a fun word.
Yes, sir.
I love it. Okay, wait, by the way, we should probably do the next hit in silent theater form.
Oh my God.
No, I don't know. I think it would be hard. We did mention that people can come, celebrate and donate. But one way they can do that is through, the upcoming shows and stuff that you guys have going on. What are some of your favorite shows that you enjoyed here at Hawaii Theater?
Well, some of my favorite ones that I've enjoyed in the past, obviously the Gym Neighbors Christmas specials were huge.
Mm-hmm.
We shared our first times on stage at Hawaii Theater. Mine was in 1997 as part of that show. That was tremendous. I really enjoyed the time that we had this incredible pianist that came in as a fundraiser for the theater many years ago with Sarah McLaughlin. That was one of the most incredible performances. And then most recently, we've had Blue Oyster Cult, we've had Jefferson Starship, we've had some tremendous shows. And now coming up, we have a Broadway show coming in, theater, Potted Potter, which is all 7 Harry Potter books in 90 minutes.
I'm obsessed. Kelly Seivig, did you hear that?
Potted Potter.
Insane.
Isn't that crazy? It's going to be amazing. So you've got to come down, check it out. All the fees that you pay on tickets at Hawaii Theater stay in Hawaii. It stays at Hawaii Theater. It helps support us. But going to a show like Potted Potter helps us tremendously because we're bringing them in from Broadway. They're on stage. It's live theater.
Mm-hmm.
And there's even going to be a live Quidditch match in the theater.
Wait, how are you going to do that?
You have to buy a ticket.
Okay. By the way, did you ever take the Pottermore test?
I did.
Well, what are you?
Guess.
Gryffindor. No. Mm. Are you Hufflepuff?
No.
I'm a Hufflepuff.
Really?
Yeah. I don't know why.
Ravenclaw.
Oh.
Sorry.
It's cool. It's okay.
Cool, right?
Ravenclaw. We're kind of the underdog.
Right. Exactly.
Okay. So this is exciting. Okay. So you mentioned a lot of upcoming shows, and even the history of Hawaii Theater. Mm-hmm. It's on your website. But something that I also learned is that the theater shut down a little bit.
Yeah.
In the 80s, right?
Right.
What happened?
So during the 80s, the theater was slated to be demolished. So at the time, Kamehameha Schools owned the fee of the land. The theater had fallen into disrepair. Consolidated Amusements said, we're done with it. Big theater's over. And so a group of community volunteers got together and bought the theater.
Love it.
and raised $36 million.
Look at that.
In the community. So this is a community house. We're a private nonprofit, and we raise money to help maintain the theater based on the vision of people like Sarah Richards mm-hmm. and many others in the community that raised all of the money that helped get us to where we are today.
I love it. Okay, yeah. You guys stay with us because in a couple of minutes, we're going to be back here live at Hawaii Theater, and we're going to talk about how you guys can be involved with Hawaii Theater by raising money.
Don't go anywhere. Living in Hawaii, going to be right back.
Was that curious?